हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग लेसन नंबर 10, डिवीजन ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल फ्रॉम 8th स्टैंडर्ड मैथमेटिक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, द वर्ड पॉलिनोमियल इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ग्रीक वर्ड पॉली मीन्स मेनी एंड नॉमियल मीन्स टर्म्स। सो पॉलिनोमियल मीन्स मेनी टर्म्स। स्टूडेंट्स, डेफिनेशन ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल इज गिवन इन यूर बुक इज इफ इंडेक्स ऑफ ईच टर्म ऑफ एन अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन इन वन वेरिएबल इज अ होल नंबर देन गिवन एक्सप्रेशन इज कॉल्ड अ पॉलिनोमियल। There are four example and we have to check which example represent a polynomial and which example represent a not a polynomial. In first example, the index of the first term is 2, which is a whole number. The index of the second term is 1, again which is a whole number. Here we can write down 3 multiplied by x to the power 0 because we know that x to the power 0 means 1 and 0 is a whole number. So this example represent a polynomial. In second example, the index of the first term is 3, which is the whole number. The index of the second term is 2, which is the whole number. The index of the third term is 1, again a whole number. And here we can write down 5 multiplied by y to the power 0 because we know that y to the power 0 means what? Equal to 1. And 0 is a whole number. So this example again represents a polynomial. In third example, the index of the first term is 1 by 2, which is not a whole number. The index of the second term is 1, but because of this index, this example is not a polynomial. In fourth example, the index of the first term is 3, which is a whole number. The index of the second term is minus 2, which is not a whole number. So because of this example is not a polynomial. Classification of polynomial: monomial, binomial and trinomial. Monomial means what? A polynomial containing only one term is called a monomial. For example, 5x, 37. 37 is a constant number, but student, we can write this as 37 multiplied by x to the power 0 because we know that x to the power 0 means 1 and 0 is a whole number. Another is binomial. A polynomial containing two distinct terms is called a binomial. For example, 3x plus 5u. Another example is 7 plus n. Student, both terms are totally distinct from each other. Here also, both the terms are totally distinct from each other. Students, the third type is trinomial. A polynomial having three terms is called a trinomial. For example, x square plus 7x plus 5u. Another example is 5x cube minus 3x square plus 7. All the three terms are present here totally distinct from each other. Here also all the three terms present here are distinct from each other. Then the next concept is degree of a polynomial. The greatest index of the variable in the given polynomial is called a degree of the polynomial. For example, 3x square plus 4x. Student, here we have to compare the index of the variable. In the first term, the index is 2. And in the second term, the index is 1. We have to consider the greatest index. Which is a greater number here? 1 or 2? 2 is the greater number. So here, degree of this polynomial is 2. In second example, here, index of the first term is 5. Index of the second term is 3. And index of the third term is 2. And the index of the fourth term is 1. Which is a greater number here? Either 5, 3, 2 or 1. 5 is a greater number. So, degree of this polynomial is a 5. Students, before solving some example, there are some important points which are very helpful for solving some examples. First point is, write the dividend and divisor in the descending order of their indices. The meaning of this sentence is we have to arrange the given polynomial in a higher index to the lower index. If it is in the standard form, keep as it is. Second point is, while dividing a polynomial, the operation of division ends when either the remainder is zero or the degree of the remainder is less than the degree of the divisor. So these two points are very important for solving the examples. Student, let us solve some example. First is to divide a monomial by monomial. Here, dividend and divisor both contain only one term. For example, 15p cube is divided by 3p. So, like a normal arithmetic division, we have to perform here division operation. So, I am writing here explanation part, that is 15p cube is divided by 3 times p. Here, we have to use the table of 3. That is 3 1s are 3 and 3 5s are 15. Student, we can write this like 5, keep as it is, and we know that this index means what? That is this number p multiply itself by 3 times. So I am writing here p cube as p multiplied by p multiplied by p, and keep the denominator as it is, 1 into p, that is p. Now look at this. Here in the numerator, between the all the terms, there is a multiplication sign is present, and one term in the numerator and in the denominator look like same, so we can cancel it. This is only possible if there is a multiplication sign is present. If there is a plus or minus sign is present, then it is not possible to cancel the term present in the numerator and denominator. After that, take the multiplication of the terms present in the numerator. So 5 keep as it is, and p into p means what? That is the p square. Here the bases are same, basis p. So when the bases are same, we can add their indices. That is 1 plus 1, that is 2. And here in the denominator is 1, that is 5p square. So this is our quotient. Write this term in the quotient. That is 5 into p square. After that, multiply this quotient with this divisor, that is 5p square, that is quotient multiplied by divisor, that is 3 into p. Now here, take the multiplication of number with number and multiplication of variable with variable. So 5 3 is 15. Again, student, here both the bases are same, that is p. When the bases are same, in that case we can add their indices. Here index is 1, so 2 plus 1, that is 3. So p to the power 2 plus 1, that is 15p cube. Now write this term just below the dividend, that is 15p cube, and after that take subtraction. Now look at this. Here the change in sign is very important. The sign of 15p cube is plus, but after multiplication of signs, that is minus into plus, it becomes minus. Now here the first term having the plus sign and the second term having the negative sign. So both the terms are look like same, so cancel it. That is the remainder is 0. Here the quotient is 5 into p square. And remainder is, this is a remainder. Is 0. And this is a divisor. And this is the dividend. Now next example, to divide a polynomial by monomial. Here the divisor is monomial, that is contain only one term, but dividend contains more than two terms, that is the polynomial. So let us start the division of this example. So here take the first term here in the explanation part, that is 6 into x cube, and divide it by divisor, that is 2x. Again same like arithmetic division, use the table of 2, that is 2 1s are 2 and 2 3s are 6. Again here write, keep 3 as it is and write x cube as x multiplied by x multiplied by x. And in the denominator 1 into x means what? That is x. Again here in the numerator between all the terms the sign of multiplication present, and one term in the numerator and the term in the denominator present look like same, that is the same variable present here, so we can cancel it. And after that take the multiplication of all the remaining terms in the numerator, that is 3 multiplied by x into x means what? That is x square. Here both the bases are same, that is base is here x, here also base is x. When the bases are same we can add their indexes, that is here the index is 1, here also 1, that is 1 plus 1, that is 2. And in the denominator here is 1 present, so after that finally we get quotient as 3 into x square. Write this term in the quotient, 3 into x square. And after that take the multiplication of quotient with the divisor. So I am taking the multiplication of quotient with divisor, that is 3x square multiplied by 2x is the quotient and this is the divisor. So take the multiplication of number with number and variable with variable. So 3 2 is 6. Again here both the variables, that is the bases are same, so we can add their indices, that is x to the power 2 plus 1, here is 1 is present, so 2 plus 1 means what? That is 3. 6 into x cube. Now write this term just below the first term of the dividend and again subtract these two terms. Both the terms look like same, but here whilst taking the subtraction change the change in sign is very important. Here 6x cube having the plus sign, but after the multiplication of sign, that is minus into plus, it becomes minus. So both the number quantities are same but having the different sign, so cancel it. After that bring this remaining term down, that is plus into 8 into x square. So after that here in the explanation part, this is the first part, this is the second. Take the division of 8 into x square upon 2x. This is the remaining parts of the dividend and this is the divisor. Again student, here we have to use the table of 2, that is 2 1s are 2 and 2 4s are 8. So 4, and we can write x square as x multiplied by x. And in the denominator 1 into x means what? That is the x. So again here x here also is present, here also present the same variable, so cancel it. And take the multiplication of remaining terms. So 4 multiplied by x means what? That is 4x. After that write this term in the quotient, that is plus 4 into x. And then take the multiplication of this quotient with the divisor, that is 4x multiplied by 2x. So 4 to the 8 and x into x means what? X square. So write down this just below this tape. And here is sign is positive, that is plus 8x square. Now here we have to take the subtraction of these two terms. Again here the sign is changed from multiplication of sign, we have to take here negative into positive, it means negative. Both the terms are again same but having the different sign. Here is sign is positive and here is sign is negative for 8 into x square. So both the terms are cancelled and we get the remainder as a 0. So here the quotient is three into x square plus 4x and the remainder is is 0. This is the quotient. And this is the remainder. Now next example is to divide a polynomial by a binomial. Here the divisor is binomial, that is contain two terms. But polynomial means what? That is dividend contain more than two terms, that is either three terms or four terms. Now for division, take the first term of the dividend, divide by the first term of the divisor, that is x. Again we can write x square as x multiplied by x and keep in the x in present in the denominator as it is. Now again here same term present in the numerator and in the denominator, so cancel this and write the remaining term as it is, that is x. Now this is the first term of the quotient, so write this term in the quotient, that is x. After that take the multiplication of this term with the divisor, that is quotient multiplied by divisor, that is x multiplied by x plus 2. Here this x multiplied by x and this x multiplied by 2 also. So I am writing here x multiplied by x, keep the middle sign as it is, and x multiplied by 2. So here both the bases are same, so we can add their indices. Here index is 1, here also index is 1. So x to the power 1 plus 1 means what? That is 2. And here x into 2, that is 2x. Now write this just below the dividend, that is x square plus 2x. Now again we have to take the subtraction of this term, so again we have to change the sign. Here the sign of x square is plus, but after multiplication of sign, that is minus into plus, it becomes minus. Minus into plus, it becomes again minus. Now both the terms are same, so cancel it. Now here we have to take the subtraction. Why we have to take the subtraction? Because the first term having the plus sign and the second term having the minus sign. So orally 4 minus 2, that is 2, and we know that when we are taking the subtraction, we have to give the sign of the greater number. So 4 is the greater number, so here we have to take the sign of the greater number. So 4 minus 2, that is plus 2, that is 2x, and bring this down, that is 2x plus 4. Now after that take this 2x and divide it by the first term of the dividend, that is x. Now here this term and this term both are same, so cancel it. So here only 2 is remaining. So write this 2 in the quotient with sign. Here the sign of plus 2 is plus. After that take the multiplication of this quotient, that is 2, with the divisor, that is x plus 2. Again this 2 is multiplied by this x and this 2 is multiplied by this 2. That is 2 multiplied by x, keep the middle sign as it is, that is plus 2 multiplied by 2. That is 2x plus 2 into 2, that is 4. Now write this just below this term. So plus 2x plus 4. Now again here we have to take the subtraction of these two terms. So again here sign is changed, that is minus into plus, it becomes minus. Minus into plus, it becomes minus. Both the terms are same. Here plus 2x is present, here minus 2x present. Terms are same but having the opposite sign, so cancel it. And here again both the terms are same but this having the plus sign and this 4 having the minus sign. So both the terms again cancel. So remainder is here 0. So in this way we have to students solve the example. I hope you understand this concept very well. Thank you.